Good morning and happy Saturday. We don't have a full build today, but we're gonna have a full weekend of some really cool new kits to show you. One on Saturday, one on Sunday. Today we're gonna start off with taking a look at the all new for 2024 AMT 1/25th scale 1960 Ford F100 pickup truck. This is a completely new tool kit. Of course, you know, the vintage kit, but they've done everything new tool, just, you know, like the Demon or like the coronets and stuff like that, completely redoing everything. It is a 3-in-1 kit. You can build it as this beautiful bone stock F100. You can do it as a custom truck with some custom parts included, or you can build it up with the included decals as this really sweet Gulf service or any gas station service vehicle. This kit does have a complete engine underneath the removable hood. So let's start taking a look at this 3-in-1 right now so you can see all the awesome parts that you'll be getting when you snag yours. And according to what I was told, these should be on their way to stores and online retailers within the week. So get ready, get your orders in, don't miss out. First up will be the truck parts, molded in white styrene and extremely crisp. We got things like our steering column, our nice beautiful stock steering wheel, fan, thin radiator hose, which it should be in scale, bottom of the interior. We've got our front seat with beautifully molded detail, dashboard with instrument cluster raised detail, all the nice detail on there. It looks like a small radio dial there. Controls, we got our stock hood, check that out. All the little vents molded open. Don't have to black wash them. Ready for the logos. So is the side of the hood. Ready for those awesome Ford Arrow logos. I call them arrows on that. Flip it over. We'll look at the interior. Basic interior design. The door panel is molded in. They're not super fancy door panels on these, so I don't think we really have to worry about it too much with them not being separate. On the next parts tree, we've got the bottom of the bed with its fenders. Nice detail molded on that. Even has bolt heads molded in. Tonneau cover as an option. That is really slick. One large piece like that with ridges so that it holds in place. Optional fender skirts. I always call them wheel pants. Drives people nuts. Those have positive mounting locations with pins on there so you can get them into the correct locations. So that's the next tree. Then we've got our frame and lower body pieces. Dual exhaust, early outlet, differential, drive shaft, springs, front of the frame. Check out these interesting, these got to be exhaust manifolds off that engine. Very, very interesting design on that in the old days. We got our belt and pulley system. Body pan right there. Yeah, nice view of that. We'll look at the top side. You can see like the mounting link lugs for that interior. So obviously you'll be putting the interior on the chassis first before we assemble that up. Got our inner fenders towards the front. Looking like a pretty simple assembly on the truck. On here, we've got our Ford tri-power, we've got our push bumper, firewall, are these body vents of some sort? We'll have to find out what that is. That's why I love building it on camera. Got our batteries, engine and transmission, oil or gas can, whatever you want to call them. We've got a loop on here that goes in the bed to hold up this big honking fire extinguisher. We've got our intake, distributor, cylinder heads, radiator on there, toolbox accessories. We've got our steelies, nice wheels on there. Obviously these are inserts for the tires, help them hold their shape. On the back, looks like we're gonna have a steel axle to put the wheels on. Wheel backs, or wheel inserts on here. You can see where the tires should fit on the inside. Maybe these are for the trailer. I bet these are for the trailer. And we've got our bed. That looked nice. Look at that Ford logo on the back. With the chain or the wire loop. Taillight locations. It's a very unique looking bed on that thing. I don't know any of the history about this F100. Didn't want to look it up. I just like to build models. I don't need to research every topic till I fall down. This is going to be fun. It's going to come out looking awesome. Beautiful model work, beautiful tooling work. And then we've got our cab. In the front, we can see where our radiator is going to mount. From the front, we can see the little vents in there. Got our windshield wipers molded in. Cab vent across the front, we can black wash. If you want to do a two-tone on the roof, should be quite easy with the way the body is designed. You can just scribe your tape all the way around and get your spraying done. Nice tall cab, kind of looks like a big rig cab, but not quite. Got the custom cab detail on the side there. You can barely see it in plastic, but it's that right there where it says custom cab. Nice looking plastic on there. I'm going to jump to the other side of the table for all the multimedia, and I'll see you there in just a moment. Starting on the opposite side of the table where I like to keep all the stuff I call multimedia, we've got two steel axles. They're just cut wire, and a wider steel axle's got to be for that trailer that's in this kit. We're going to look at that in just a moment, so don't worry. But yeah, they're not chrome. They're just cut wire, and I actually prefer it like that. I mean, there's no reason for it to be chrome. It just adds to the difficulty of inserting it into the wheel. For transparent parts, we've got tail lights, marker lights, and a nice dome light for up on the roof, a nice wigwag, as I always call them. Then we move on to the clear parts. Back glass, front glass, large mounting area on the roof of the cab. Let's look at the cab on the inside. Yeah, there we go. Got our pins in there. So yeah, that's where that's going to mount in. That should be make it much nicer. And it's got headlights. Nice plastic headlights. We've got a chrome tree here. Trophy, valve covers, lug wrench. Looks like some optional gauges possibly. Small antennas. Torque wrench hiding on there. Pump fire extinguisher, air horns. Tri-power carburetors and air cleaners. We've got a nice set of custom wheels on there. Stock hubcaps, or custom hubcaps, the smoothie hubcaps. Those are sharp looking. Nice tree there. We've got a second chrome tree. Best thing on this tree right here, check out those Ford logos. Just be super careful detaching those. Those are these little beauties right there. They've done a nice job. I would recommend doing your red work inside that before you detach them. We got some optional side pipes, stock Ford hubcaps, bumpers, grill and headlights, black washing or black paint inside there is going to make a big difference. Custom grill. We've got a column shifter, or you can do a floor shifter as we saw on the other parts tree. We've got a beautiful set of small mirrors. There's your custom column shifter with tachometer. You can do either or with the truck. One set, two sets. We got black wall tires for the trailer. Nice tread pattern. They are semi-hollow, but insanely stiff. The truck tires are black wall one side with no name brand engraved in. White wall on the other, no name brand engraved in. Bias ply tread, and again, really, really stiff. So getting them over these wheels, definitely going to be a time of trial. That's going to be difficult to stretch those over. You're going to want to warm these tires up in some warm water or with a heat gun. Warm them up a lot and then stretch them over your wheels when you're all done, because that's going to be a very, very tight fit with vinyl that stiff. They'll sand nicely because they're made out of stiff vinyl, but getting them over there is going to be a challenge. Then we've got the paper goods. We've got our decal sheet here, road service. We've got, it looks like it says either Roy or Ray or Jenny in the white letters there for the names. You can see them there. Some scallop striping, custom cab decals, dash gauge decals, tachometer decal, hazard mark for that push bumper, and then the Rays Automotive, Gulf logos, moon eyes. Very small decal sheet, but a lot of stuff on there for the service truck. License plates, everything you could want on there to detail a nice vehicle. For the truck, the last of the paper goods, the truck itself, beautiful AMT manual. Everything should be quite easy to assemble. We got the engine in one step, interior in the second. So I don't think it's going to be very hard to put this together. The parts count isn't massive, but you're getting an engine, you're getting custom parts, and they do go over all the ways to put the truck together, customize it, use your option parts like your side pipes, your the louvers, that's what those are, louvers for the hood were those serrated parts, fender skirts, side pipe, they call them lake pipe, lakes pipe, oil cans, all the accessories. So now we're going to look at the little trailer, which is a kit of itself. Now, pulling out that trailer, it gets its own chrome parts tree with hubs on there, hitch pin, looks like a light mount, got our taillights and license plates, hitch on there. So that's nice. So this would mount to just about anything, and then that's the ball on there. Nice done on the chrome on the trailer. And molded in white styrene, we've got leaf springs, axle, and fenders as one unit. Nice super round fenders, definitely part of the 60s in that design. Then we've got our tongue, that just kind of snaps onto that ball. We've got our wheels for the trailer, same type of steelies that the truck has. Diamond plate, and it's very in scale with that tread. It's like an expanded metal tread, not diamond plate. It's like a thin expanded metal. So that's all styrene on new molds. We've got the frame of the trailer. Pretty sharp looking where our runners are going to lay. Over the top of the frame, molded in a U shape. And we've got a face plate. This is smooth on both sides. with these mounts here. So it's so cool. You get two entire kits in the box of stuff that people have wanted for a long, long time. Then we've got the expanded metal ramps and runners on the trailer. You can see the sides of it with the tabs. Wheel backs. Various mounting locations on that trailer. I like that expanded metal instead of diamond plate. It's kind of a neat design texture on there. And finally, all the stuff in the kit leads us to the instruction manual for that trailer. You can get a good look at it right there. You can see the sides will be up. We got our travel area, and they show you how to set everything up on that trailer with our fenders. Yeah, see our wheel backs, our wheels, everything in there. Awesome. So this will be built up very, very soon. Stay tuned. Have yourself a nice Saturday. Tomorrow, we're going to be unboxing another brand new kit that everyone's waited for. So you will get to see that then. We're not going to have a full build until Wednesday, but we'll probably be fitting in another unboxing or something even after the two are done this Saturday and Sunday. As always, I want to thank Round 2 Models for sending these kits over. I've had these couple for a while, but they asked me to hold off to them. They didn't think they were going to make them in the shops as soon as they are, but they should be on their way to stores right now or within the next week. So you folks should be able to start picking these up within a couple weeks. I will see all of you at the next review. We'll be right back.